A former official of the Philippine ICT Department raises concerns over what he called questionable transmission of election results. Former ICT Undersecretary Eliseo Rio says in just the first hour after polling precincts closed on May 9th, over 20 million votes were already transmitted. Rio notes that's highly improbable, if not impossible, since the printing of copies of election results alone takes at least 30 minutes. Rio says he first raised this concern before the Commission on Elections back in July. He has yet to receive any response.
Ano sa tingin nyo ang posibleng nangyari?
Preloaded ang transparency server. Alam na kung sino ang naglagay ng data na yon. Alam nila kung ano ang magiging official count. Yun ang aming kwento. No? Kaya pero importante na ito ay i-counter ng COMELEC mismo, and yeah. The only way they can counter is to show yung actual transmission report. Ang amin lang gusto ay talagang mapakita na malinis at honest yung ating election. Because yun dapat ang ating concern. Kung hindi natin ito malinis ngayon, aba, ito na ang election type ng election natin sa 2023 at sa 2025 forever. Mm-hmm.
As for the COMELEC, it asserts there are no irregularities in the May 9 polls.
Ibinigay na po namin ang datos sa JCOC. Kung kami po magbibigay sa lahat nitong datos na ito, maari pong ang mangyari niyan, napakarami pong dokumento. What can prevent anybody na lang hihingi ng documents na napakaguluminous po? Palino pong sinasabi namin dito talaga, on the graph which was presented to everybody, nung talaga pong sa first 2 hours, nag-peak na po talaga tayo. What can we expect po talaga? We improve the system, we improve the servers.
Hundreds of passengers stranded at the Mactan Cebu International Airport after a Korean Air passenger plane overshot the runway Sunday night. Our very own Annie Perez now joins us with the latest. Annie.
Yes, Carmina. As of the moment, there are still a lot of passengers stranded at the Mactan Cebu International Airport, but officials of this airport said earlier in its press briefing that they are looking into opening the whole of its runway by midnight tomorrow. This after Korean Airbus 330 with flight number KE631 overshot in the runway last night. Attorney Glenn Napuli, Assistant General Manager of the MCIA Aviation Authority, said it will take some time to remove the aircraft. As of the moment, they are still defueling the plane. And right after, they will follow the actual removal of the aircraft from the runway. While that will take some time, their initial plan is for today to open a short portion of the runway. From 3.3 kilometers, they are shortening it to 2.6 kilometers so that they can accommodate and make priority 6 aircraft that are currently stranded in the Mactan Cebu International Airport so that it can immediately leave. And this includes one Turkish airline Airbus. As of the moment, the airline companies who have respective passengers who are at the airport waiting for announcements and also those included in the stranded flights, they are being taken care of, given food, and the rest who requested accommodation because they would be possibly staying for one more night in Cebu, they're also given all their requests and basic needs. Others also went to the airport to ask for refund and to rebook their flight. It was also stressed earlier in the press briefing that KAAP gave a go signal for the aircraft to land despite bad weather condition because they saw that it was suitable and doable for the aircraft. And as to the actual turn of events and what happened prior to the emergency landing, they are not disclosing information yet, as they said that investigation is still ongoing. And that's the latest here from Cebu, Carmina.